Wake up, Tucson. It's your town. Get up and get involved. It's Wake Up Tucson with Chris DeSimone and Joe Higgins.
A little less conversation, a little more action, please. All this aggravation ain't satisfaction in me. A little more bite, a little less bark, a little less fight, a little more spark. Open up your heart and maybe satisfy me. Satisfy me, baby.
All right, 7:07 in the morning. Welcome back to the Wake Up Tucson show. The new ball from Walgreens is rocking in the back, man. Higgins,
you like that?
It's a little smaller. We have gentle hands, Ed.
We do.
We're white collar workers. That's what happens. Sorry, buddy.
I got calluses from CrossFit. Look at there.
I
should report to you every morning what we did in CrossFit the day before.
You can.
Burpees and V-ups.
Oh, really?
The new one. We did the rope thing.
Really?
Very
had
nice.
To put burpees. A sled with weight and run around the thing.
Yeah, I'm telling you,
boys.
You're looking hot, dude.
Thank you.
Majorly hot.
CrossFit, it's called DNA 520. It's over on Camp Lowell and
Swan.
Go check it out.
All right.
Hardest work you ever do.
And, of course, you're doing the QMed weight loss program.
I am. We're coming up on a year, man. The end of this month has been a year.
That's true.
I know.
I have lost probably 38 to 40 pounds and kept it off.
Nice.
In the year.
Nice.
So,
it works.
And Joe's...
And you guys are looking good. May I ask real quick? I know we got a lot
of
money. If I wanted to do something like that, how much would it cost me to do that? Month and then I got to extrapolate
so
to a year.
So depending on medical things and medical costs.
The startup is, blood tests and all that
budget
stuff.
Budget about $350
a
the
month?
First month. And then after that, it goes down.
Really?
And then depending how you do food. If you buy your own food or we do food
but
for
if you,
you
get that healthy and that good looking. Yeah.
Well, and you think of the cost of health care and obesity on your future.
We're damn good looking.
Okay.
Yeah. Let me set this up real quick. So I'm watching this thing on the old interweb yesterday.
You're talking about this $100,000 contract for the fries, cookies,
no.
and the three postings.
No.
Wait, there's more?
I told you. That was just the appetizer to the crappetizer.
Right. Again. You and I are schmucks for not setting up a company.
I know.
And picking a weird name and going after these things. Dude, you could bid $10,000 on that and still come out like it's smelling like a rose.
Yep. Yeah.
Why don't we do that? We'll get Ed involved.
Well, let's
Ed,
look.
You can do part of it.
I can do the press releases.
You can do the cookie part.
I can do the cookie part.
Well, let's go to the only person on the Pima County Board of Soups who actually gives a damn about taxpayers, Allie Miller. Allie, good morning, dear.
Good morning. How are you? It sounds like you guys are looking just great there in studio.
Oh,
buffed. We're buffed.
We can see our toes buffed. Again.
Right. I don't have to bend over to tie my shoe.
I just started my program, too, so you just wait.
All right, Allie. Let's see it.
Give me 6 months.
All right.
We'll give you
who's most buffed.
We'll give you 7 months.
7 months. Okay.
Make it happen.
And then we'll do the buff challenge. We'll
there you
have
go.
A race up to Mount Wrightson.
So yesterday, your agenda items for prioritizing money in the budget for roads turned into quite a hootenanny.
It was a hootenanny. I was rather surprised. I mean, Chuck put my constant contact memo in the background material. Apparently that drew the ire of Chuck.
Well, his face turned bright red.
Anytime you put something in writing.
Purple.
Yeah. Anytime you put it in writing is when it really gets fiery.
Now, just refresh the folks' memories. What exactly was what were the agenda items for?
Okay,
so people know. Let's set this up.
Well, the item that I put on the agenda was simply to direct the county administrator to look at the current year budget and see if there were areas that we could cut in an effort to increase funding for road repair and pavement preservation. And I had some recommendations for items that I have been tracking all year that we noted when we did the budget. Actually, District 1 did a budget review, the first one ever last year, and we noted some items that looked kind of funky. So we kept track of them all year long, and one of them was $26 million for outside non-medical consultants and service providers. So we looked at that. It was for $26 million in the budget. Well, we tracked what the Board of Supervisors had approved. We also got in contact with the purchasing department, added up all the money. They've only spent $4 million of that $26 million year to date. So I recommended, hey, we could pull $10 to $15 million out of there. You know, I don't know what they've got left for the year, but, you know, the fiscal year ends June 30th. And I also had the allocation for the $15 million to the U of A Medical Center for education of resident doctors.
So the $26 million is outside of the $15 million. That's two separate numbers. Okay.
Yes, the $26 million was a total that they had sp- spread throughout the budget. When we did the review, there were 15 of us that did the review, and we all came together, and every person that was on the budget review committee, they were all volunteers that came into my office. Every one of them noted, hey, there's a huge amount of money in my particular area for outside medical non-medical consultants. So we added them all up.
It's like the FTE issue. I think where they hold all those budget items in your FTE of each department, but they never get spent, but the budget still sits there.
Right. And so, you know, there were a couple of other items in there. And I said, in light of the last year's ending balance of $45 million of surplus, and they reallocated them another $15 million, which gave the U of A $30 million last year, I said, let's look at this now. I think we can pull some money out, and I recommend a $10 to $15 million out of
this
one.
So wait a minute. U of A got $30 million when it was allocated 15.
Last year they got there was a $45 million budget surplus, and Chuck recommended that they get an additional $15 million last year.
Wow.
So they ended up with $30 million last year.
Wow.
And I believe the total. I think we have a. Summed it up, I think they've gotten over the years something like $178 million.
Is that okay. How we make up for the shortfall from the state?
Okay, hold on.
Yeah,
a second.
Yeah, plus give them a hospital of $48 million.
Hold on one second, because there's going to be some investigative reporters out there listening.
Yeah.
This original deal was a 10-year deal for $125 million, right? It went through.
Correct.
In 5.5 years, they burned through the $125 million, and now we're giving them back more.
Medicine's hard.
With the $125 million we gave the University Hospital to take over Kena, what did they buy, guys? Did they buy a Da Vinci $5 million state-of-the-art surgical device? What did they put into that money that could have been used in other parts of their operation? What did they throw on the taxpayer?
The only thing I remember is a bunch of medicine disappearing.
That was under Carmona before the deal. That was a couple million bucks
worth
of OxyContins or something like that. But watch that number. Someone should investigate where that 125 went, what they bought, what assets are sitting in Keno that belong now to the U of A.
That'll
hospital.
Blow Fergie's
from
future
the,
job with Chuck, though.
From the county taxpayers.
So now, one thing I got to ask you is, so then...
That's all I did, is I innocently put this item on the agenda because I thought it was a fiscally responsible thing to do, was to analyze and look at these expenditures.
Would you use the mismanagement word in the
I used the mismanagement of HERF revenue, and that really got the ire of Chuck. He was so upset about, he says other counties and cities use these to pay for bonds and salaries and overhead, et cetera. And I agreed with him. I said, yes, they do. But you don't have to be, it doesn't take much to look around. You can't spin it. You can't use a spreadsheet. You can't do anything believe that this money has not been going to roads. There's no need for analysis or spin. The potholes are the potholes. They're there. And the money has been mismanaged, and I'll say it again and again and again. It was mismanaged under the current leadership of Sharon Bronson, Ramon Valadez, Ray Carroll, Richard Elias, and Chuck Huckleberry. They kept him in as the county administrator, and they have mismanaged the HERF revenue. There's close to $600 and some odd million that was in excess of the bond payments that they used. For what?
So they say
they used it for salaries, but end of the day, that money was mismanaged because not a single road was repaired in the last 10 to 15 years until Mike Helen ran, and then he came out and said he got $10 million from Chuck to repair roads, which I find that very interesting, but he did get some roads repaired during his campaign. And until then, there was nothing done for the roads.
So here's the thing. So this was a... yes, you can agree with Chuck and say, hey, yes, other towns have used the money for this, but those other towns didn't let their roads go to crap.
They also use the money for road repair as well. They don't just say, yeah, we're not going to do any road repair at all. And I cited the example of Oral Valley, Marana, Maricopa County. All you got to do is look all around.
You know, it's funny. Chuck's a transportation guy. He cut his teeth in transportation. I think he's embarrassed as hell that he let the place get as bad as he did.
The tide went out. Yeah.
Now, real quick, before we didn't even get to the real crescendo of this story. The agenda item. You had a lot of people show up at 9 o'clock when the meeting starts.
Yeah.
But when did the agenda item actually hit? When did it actually happen?
It was close to 4 o'clock in the afternoon before it actually hit.
Now, was it delayed? Was it moved around at all by Sharon, or is it just the natural progression of the meeting?
There were some items that were moved around, and then it was there were some rezonings that took a lot of time because there were a lot of speakers on those. So, and then she combined this item with the item on the agenda, which had nothing to do with it, which was to approve our current road budget for the year, which there was $5 million that Chuck had allocated out of the general fund to be used for roads, and each district roughly got $1 million.
All right, hold it right there. We call that a tease. When we come back, we have Allie Miller on the line. We're going to talk about pretty much one of the more, they do a lot of disgraceful things down here, but this is one of the most disgraceful things. And
tell me they didn't trot kids out, Chris.
Oh, absolutely.
For the children.
Oh, we got, sure. It's all about the children. Oh, no. We got it all. And Ray Carroll and the three Democrats really had a real party yesterday.
Yeah, Ray Kozacik and the Democrats did have a great party, and they,
Something else. So if you want to hop in, 790-2040 is the phone number.
Not the kids. Please tell me we didn't bring kids into this discussion. Please tell me no kids were involved.
Wake Up Tucson, 1030 The Voice, 790-2040. WakeUpTucson@gmail.com. We got Allie Miller on the line. Wow. Pima County, man, you're something else.
That's the sound of the men working on the chain. Gang. That's the sound of the
You can't believe everything you read, but you can believe Wake Up Gang. Tucson. Morning 6 to 8 on AM 1030 KVOI, The Voice.
Take this job and shove it. I ain't working here no more. A woman done left and took all the reason I was working for.
We're doing job and labor songs today because everybody wants to be for pro jobs.
We're making jobs here. We're making jobs. Yep.
7:21 in the morning. We will get to all your phone calls before it's all over. We'll also get to Dan Murray's before the end of the hour. We got Allie Miller, Supervisor District 1. We will get, like I said, everyone who's on call, we'll get to you in a second. So, Allie, we get to like a 3-4 o'clock agenda item on this on trying to reprioritize the budget for fixing some roads. Some people start filing in to the old chambers from the east side?
Yeah, a whole lot of, about 10 people, 10 or 12 people came in from the southeast side of town. One of them said they were representing the school out there, the Vail School District.
It was Calvin Baker's communication director.
And they said that they were going to offer up $100,000 if Pima County would put up the money to fix Colossal Cave Road. I have no doubt Colossal Cave Road, like all the roads in Pima County, is in disgraceful condition. But one of them talked to a friend of mine who was sitting in the audience, and they said, this is the first time we've ever been here. We were called to come. And it was very clear that this group was called to come because they didn't show up at 9 o'clock in the morning. They showed up at 3:30 in the afternoon, just before this event happened.
So this is the kids,
right?
This
was all pre-planned. and you know, as I've said before, many developers have talked about punishment for not getting contracts and the bullying and their fear for speaking up for what they need because of the retaliation they will get from Pima County.
Right.
Well, I experienced it firsthand yesterday when Richard Elias, after these people filed in and spoke, Richard Elias made the motion to remove the money from my district and give it to an emergency funding for Colossal Cave Road because of the children out there in that school district, that this money needed to be used for that. I have a memo in my hand dated November 14th from Mr. Huckleberry approving my pavement preservation projects that we had agreed to. It's one of my staff who worked very closely with the Department of Transportation and Mr. Huckleberry back in November 14th. They approved these projects and said it was just fine for the pavement preservation. And then yesterday, it was clearly in retaliation for me challenging the status quo, questioning the spending, asking the tough questions, and this is what is going to happen to anyone. And you know, developers have told me this for years, and now I have experienced it. It was personal for Chuck Huckleberry. It was not about finding the best solution for our problems in Pima County. It was clearly about him. And you do not dare challenge him, because if you do, he will get the rest of the board, and they all sat up, lined up just like ducks, and they played it very well, and they did exactly as they were directed, and they turned on me and moved my pavement preservation money out of district one. This is an insult to every single resident of District 1.
How much money did they pull from District 1?
It was somewhere close to $1 million. We were lucky we got one project done. Yeah, I know. That's enough to fill the potholes and the potholes.
Well, I wonder who pays the most property taxes for their homes.
I know. This is the amazing thing. Is
Oral District Valley, 1,
there was a lady there from District 1
right.
who spoke about her neighborhood. I think it was Coronado Foothills neighborhood.
Yeah.
And she said it has been 28 years since anything's been done to our roads. And they come in and they throw pavement into the potholes, and the roads are just crumbling. And she sat there and she witnessed this. So I have witnesses to what took place there yesterday, that people that are going to testify in the HOA meetings that I go to, and many people were just amazed. They said, I've never seen such a lack of decorum and respect in my life. The body language of these people. And
oh, this is a coordinated attack like you would never believe.
Oh, yeah,
and
it was.
Now, all you Pollyannish Republicans, or some of you Ray Carroll Kool-Aid drinkers that say, oh, it's just some sort of, Ray just disagrees with Allie on some things. No, Ray hates her guts, guys. Let's get this straight out. Ray hates Allie. We got it. All right. Ray is a very unhappy dude, and he really wanted to get you, and he got you good, all right? So first of all, you needed Sharon Bronson to keep the agenda, to coordinate with the people from the Vail School District to show up, first of all. That had to happen. So
yeah.
She did her part, all right? At the same time, you have to have Richard Elias make the motion to rip the money away from District 1 to pay for Ray's stuff.
Yeah, and I
because you can't have it come from Ray, because that would look really way obvious.
You got to get Calvin Baker.
It was Ramon that seconded the motion, and as I pointed out in yesterday's meeting, out of the $350 million bond funds that are only supposed to be used for new roads and widenings, Ramon has a $7 million fund called DOT 41 that he can use for anything he wants. So he has that $7 million in addition to the allotment that
he's the only one who has a $7 million DOT fund?
The only one. It was Dan Ekstrom that got that money, moved into that, and it's now down to $7
million. So here's the best part. So then Ray or somebody had to, let's say it's in his district, someone had to go get Calvin Baker to either willingly or unwillingly come to go play on this thing. They
yeah.
go send the Vail people to say, oh, Colossal Cave Road, the children.
Yes. And
all
what
right.
about the children in District 1? What about the children on Thornydale, Mountain View High
Didn't
School?
Didn't we already have someone killed at Thornydale
yeah.
by Mountain View High School?
Yeah.
Yes, we did. And the condition of Thornydale Road that school buses drive down every day, which was one of the areas that, even though it's supposed to be on the RTA list, it's now been pushed out to 2018 because we're doing another very important. We had some pavement preservation that we were going to do in that area because it's so dangerous, but that has now been pulled because it's around a school area, and school buses drive through there every day, and it's very, very dangerous. And it is an emergency. I think every road in Pima County is an emergency. But this was clearly, you know, retaliation and by Mr. Huckleberry and the board, by them. They took all of my repair money for the rest of the fiscal year. And Ray Carroll is turned into the lapdog of Chuck Huckleberry. He brought in those constituents to legitimize the removal of monies from District 1.
Ray Carroll went out of his way
yes.
to get at you, okay, to screw everyone in District 1.
That's
so
right.
If you're a Republican in District 1, Uber Republican, I'll put air quotes on the radio, went out of his way to screw you to spite Allie. Do you get that, guys, yet? Do you get that yet? That's what he did to you.
In the end of the day, this is Chicago bullying. This isn't a way to manage a county. I vote in the best interest of the taxpayers above all else. And for this board, the petty vindictiveness is just shocking to me. I've worked in a lot of companies, and the companies, you know, you work with people you don't like, but you always do what's best for the company. This is petty vindictiveness, just as these developers have described to me over
now,
and over again.
Now, here's the other thing, too. You got Ray is in prime form on this, okay?
Oh.
I know the videos, you guys are going to have the videos come out soon, because
yeah.
You guys do your own video, because I wouldn't trust Chuck's videos to save my life. But you got to watch him after the right after they rip off the $1 million out of District 1, as he's talking to Sharon, he's laughing about it like you never would believe.
Oh,
all right?
Yes. Oh, yes.
He had
a good laugh.
He also starts trying to pontificate about how in politics you have to be a good compromiser. All right? And he spends a few minutes touting the political skills of former Tucson Mayor George Miller.
Who?
The wallpaper hanger.
You know, you guys, if we were on a shiny city in the hill and everything ran fine and jobs were plentiful and real estate values were increasing and roads were fixed, playing Chicago politics is part of the game. This happens in other markets.
Absolutely.
Don't kill me that we're not serious about this. When Ann Day was in office for all those years, she kind of went along, got along, and she got the goods. She got the goodies in the minority.
She really didn't, Joe.
Well, if you look at the bonding.
72% of the roads are failed in Pima County in District 1 versus 62% in the rest of the county. We have the most failed roads, and they took our money away. Ann Day was down there. And
so in the article, they make a comment about the last few bonds that went through really went in her district, because that's
where
the growth was.
The reason they came up in District 1 is because that's where all the growth was.
Yeah, that's where the growth was.
Common sense that you would have to build roads where the growth is.
Right.
And it wasn't because they were doing any special favors for District 1, but Chuck likes to throw that up in my face, but it is the place that where all the growth was taking place, and you had to build the roads.
Right. But, Allie, having been a candidate against Ann Day, I look at this county, and I saw the same thing you're seeing. I looked at the way it's run. I looked at my kids in high school and looking to inherit this place in the next 5-10 years. What are they going to have? I look at the future direction of where we're going as a community, and I said, I'm going to run for that seat. You're there, and you're doing what you have to do, and this is why you're elected to do it, and it's not fun, and it's difficult that you're in the middle of the crosshairs on these things. But you got to get the word out. You got to tell the people how this county is run, because it will not stop until you shine the light of day through radio stations, through blog posts, through Facebook conversations, through your constant contact emails, to let the world know how this place is actually working. Because our time and our future is dwindling quickly as a community. We chronicle it every morning on this show, guys. You can't be more clear than we're telling you right now. This is petty. This is vindictive. This is what's keeping large investments from outside markets coming to our marketplace to play here, because they don't want to play in this odd, weird sandbox where I got to pay this consultant, and I got to hire this attorney, and count these three votes to get my project put through. And it's absolutely killing our community.
I wish a blowhard like Ray Carroll would use this sort of machinations and hard work that he did to screw Alley over to actually come up with some sort of strategy to make Pima County better for small business. Because that guy's never had an original idea in his life.
There's a scoreboard going on here. And look at the scoreboard, man. You guys have been in office and running this place for 25 years, the majority. How's it working out for you?
Alley,
it's not.
Alley, can you hang on for one more segment?
Sure.
All right, let's do that. 7:32 in the morning. We got one more segment with Allie Miller. 790-2040. We'll get to your phone calls. I know you guys are waiting on. We'll get to your phone calls. Dan Murray in the fourth hour talking about the rodeo parade. He's the grand marshal tomorrow. So wake up, Tucson. 10:30, boys. This is for Higgins.
Working for the MCA. Leonard Skinner.
Wake up, Tucson, with Joe Higgins and Christy Simone on 1030 KVOI, The Voice.
Get a job.
7:37 in the morning. We got Supervisor Allie Miller on the line. Allie, when do we think the videos from your office of what went down yesterday in the Banana Republic of Pima, when are they going to hit the streets?
They should be hitting the probably mid-morning.
Okay.
They'll be, because the meeting didn't end until a little after 4 yesterday, so they didn't have time to pull them together. They're going to be putting them all up. They're going to be clipping them into small clips. And the one of Ray Carroll laughing after he took the money is definitely going to be up. And also the one where they put the gentleman in. I shouldn't call him a gentleman. The guy who got in and spoke about being removed from my office last week. Did you notice that?
I didn't catch that part.
Oh, okay. They allowed him to speak during the discussion on the HERF funds. But, you know, my favorite line of the day was when Chuck talked about them, you know, that my Constant Contact and the myth of tax increases and mismanagement of taxpayer funds. That was my favorite line yesterday. And end of the day, everyone knows it. It's time that people really, I did almost 50 town halls and HOA meetings my first year in office. I spent a tremendous amount of time out in the community, and I'm doing the same this year. We have 3 town halls coming up starting in March, and they're on my Facebook page. They're on my website. You can call my office, 724-2738. And we want a huge number of people at those HOA meetings. I'm sure Chuck will have his people there as usual. And
hey, like I told you yesterday, you are doing what you said you were going to do from the first door you knocked on when you ran for supervisor, and you beat their boy Mike Helen. Vic Williams is $125,000, and Adam Quasman's towel boy very handily telling everyone that you want accountability for the money, you want transparency, and that's what you're doing. So. Don't ever. I know it's tough because sometimes it feels like you're staff against the entire world in this one. But
well, it's nothing less than I expected. I didn't expect an environment, but the vitriol and just the unbelievably just pettiness just blows my mind.
Well, good thing there's another helpful Republican on the board to help.
You
expect to be working with adults in an adult kind of way. That's all you're asking. And then after that, you can disagree. Yeah.
Yeah, and it's taxpayer money. It's taxpayers' money that we're working with, that we're playing these games with. And the thing of it was, that, you know, for that $26 million, that was just one pot of money that I pulled up as a suggestion. It's Mr. Huckleberry's job to go and find the money. And they absolutely refused to even try. You know, we're cut to the bone. They refused to even try when I point out only $4 million of that $26 million has been
spent.
Well,
the problem with all four of them, five of them, including Chuck, is once when your check is cashed and it goes into the bank of Chuck, it's their money now. It's,
yeah.
It has that naughty taxpayer stink removed. Let's go to the phones. Let's go to Bill number 2 on line 4. Billy, what's going on, bud?
Hey, good morning, everybody. Allie, I want to thank you for all you've done and the hard work you're putting in there and the arrows and the BS that you got to put up with. You're a tough cookie, and I appreciate it.
Oh,
now,
thank
I just,
you.
You're welcome. And I'm Joe and Chris, this almost, and maybe I'm wrong, I've been out of business a long time, this almost stinks like sexual harassment by the boys in the know. What, does that sound like something like that to you?
Feels like a war on women, but what I will tell you, what I think my thing
is, it's about philosophy. It's not getting in line. I mean, it's retribution for speaking
out. I think
out
more importantly, if you think about it, I had to have a little bit of coordination between you had Sharon with the agenda, Richard with the suggestion, and then Ray bringing in the people from Vail. At all, how do you they just came in magically? Of course,
yeah.
They didn't.
At 3:30, yeah, it was very well coordinated. Yes,
but I mean,
thing is, that's three people out of five.
Yeah, but
Attorney General, how about the open meeting law? How about that?
Yeah, we'll hear about that soon, I'm sure, and that will be an issue that will be brought up because my pavement preservation was signed off and approved by Chuck Huckleberry on November 14th, 2013. I've got the memo. And for them to go and do this, this is another thing. And just the coordination, they kept going in and out of the room together, too, as well, during the breaks. It's all on video because they knew what they were. I mean, this was clearly coordinated. And hopefully the lady who told someone that this was her first meeting and that she was called and told to attend will fess up.
Yeah.
Who called her to attend this meeting if she's interviewed?
Yeah.
All of their names are on the record, so I do hope that they get contacted by the Attorney General's office and asked, who asked you to come to these meetings?
In the corporate world, people get sued and beat up on sexual harassment for a lot less than what you're going through. And I think these guys need to be put on notice.
It's hard to go. I mean, I know what you're saying, but it's hard. That's a real hard one. That's a stretch right now.
But if they're going to play that kind of a game, everybody can play that kind of a game. So, all right, guys.
Bill, thanks for the call, bud. Let's go to Joe on line three. Joe, you're on with Chris, Joe, and Allie Miller. What's up, buddy?
What's up, y'all?
Welcome back.
Hey, well, we missed you.
It's all right. We missed you.
Well, back at you, man. Yeah. You know what? This is the deal. This just in. There was a motion by Supervisor Elias for you, Allie, for you to shave your head and donate your hair to the bald people of Vail.
Thank you, Joe.
Are you cool with that?
Yeah.
Okay, no. All right, all jokes aside, you know what? I commend you for your videos, the open meeting laws, but I think I'm wondering if we can't all help you, because I know you're tired from this, and I think we need open source government, open source ledgers, and real time computing power is totally able to do that job. And if we were able to really look in with you on what's happening, what the process is, who's sitting at the table, why shouldn't Joe and his company be able to compete in a real meaningful way?
I think I'm making a new company.
you
want to deal with me, Joe?
we'll call it Joe Squared.
Joe Squared, right. He's $100,000 a pop. Are you kidding me?
Well, I mean, why shouldn't it? But, you know, and then just for us to be able to help you, why should you sit there and be shoveling all this yourself?
Well, I did try to get the videos posted online, so you know, the county videos, so that people could see them.
But there is something to what Joe's saying, okay? Look at the people who have suffered under the hands of these folks for decades, all right? Now, I know this is a broken record. Where is the stinking Pima County Republican Party, all right? Forget about Ray for right now. He's the whole other story. But let's not even talk about it. Just about, I have a Republican supervisor who is trying to bring accountability and transparency to the political machine that has been kicking their head in the dirt for the last 25 years, and there's no one from the Pima GOP helping you at all. Zero. Zero. Oh, business community? I guess you've either moved out of town, which we know, Joe.
They're moving.
Okay.
We've talked about that.
Or you've just given in. All right, but they're just going to keep coming after you. If they can do this to her in the middle of everybody, what are they going to do to you? It's just going to get worse. If you want a signpost of the highway to hell in Pima County, it just happened yesterday at 3:57 in the afternoon.
Well, this is the one thing that I always tell folks is, yes, this is happening to me, but the business community, they have got to stop funding these people for elections. My God, they just give them money over and over
again. Hey, Cox Communications cut all four of them money this year out of their political pack. Yes. So if you're getting Cox Cable, you're helping all these people get back in the office to do exactly what they do to you. So I got to go, everybody.
Open source government would reveal all that. We could see who is the bandits, and then it would put a stop to all this government, politician, official theater that we see of who's mad at who and who's treating everybody bad, you know, and then we could actually talk about movement politics, and instead of hearing the stories of how fatigued Allie is.
Well, we invite people to volunteer at our office, and we did have a volunteer budget committee last year that actually helped review the budget, because we got it when the public got it. So if you're willing to come down and volunteer to help do that again this year, we'd love
Let's
to help.
Let's go online.
Help.
Right. Joey, thanks for your help, buddy.
Thanks, guys. See
ya. Allie, Eric, hold on. I'll get to you in a second. Allie, have a great day, and buck up, and keep fighting.
Look at the scoreboard, folks. 25 years of rule. Thanks, we know what we got. Look at the scoreboard. Just look at the scoreboard.
Let's go to Eric real quick, and then we'll get to Dan Murray's after the break. Eric, what's going on, buddy?
Yeah, hey. This is why I hate Tucson. This is so outrageous that, you know, and I'm a Republican, I think this is grounds to recall Ray Carroll. You're not going to recall the Democrats because of how they control their districts, but to show the next person who may get that office, if the recall is successful, this guy needs to be booted from office, and everybody should call his office, flood his office with calls, and tell him they're going to be part of a recall. This guy needs to be thrown out on his ear. And I'm a Republican. This is beyond outrageous. Get him out of there, and that's the remedy. Recall him.
All right, Eric. Thanks for the call, buddy. 790-2040 is the phone number.
740-8449. 740-8449 is his number. Give him a call. Let him know what you think. How's it working? Or is it? Big question we got to ask ourselves.
A little broken, baby. A little broken. Dan Murray's KOLD News and the Grand Marshal of the Tucson Rodeo Wingding, if we will, parade tomorrow morning. He's on the line. Wake up, Tucson.
I found a picture of you.
It's your town. Get up and get involved. It's Wake Up Tucson with Joe Higgins and Christy Simone. To replace in the past, we've been cast out of.